This video explains human skeleton, both the axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. The cartoon to begins the study of skeleton. Let us see the various bones in human body. There are a total of 206 bones present in an adult human being. Bones are hard, due to calcium salts present in the matrix, whereas cartilage contains chondroitin salts. The human skeleton can be divided into the axial skeleton of 80 bones, and appendicular skeleton of 126 bones. Axial skeleton, 80 bones. It includes skull, vertebral column, ribs and sternum. Appendicular skeleton, 126 bones. It includes pectoral and pelvic girdle and limbs. Study the table carefully, and make sure that human skeleton is made up of 206 bones. This diagram shows the skull. Skull includes cranium with 8 bones articulated by suture joint, facial bones with 14 bones and ear ossicles of 6 bones. The skull is composed of 2 sets of bones, cranial and facial, that totals to 22 bones. Cranial bones are 8 in number. They form the hard protective outer covering, cranium for the brain. The facial region is made up of 14 skeletal elements which form the front part of the skull. A single U-shaped bone called hyoid is present at the base of the buccal cavity and it is also included in the skull. Each middle ear contains 3 tiny bones, malleus, incus, and stapes, collectively called ear ossicles. The skull region articulates with the superior region of the vertebral column with the help of 2 occipital condyles, dicondylic skull. Let us observe Varios bones of vertebral column. Vertebral column is formed by 26 units called vertebrae. It extends from the skull. Each vertebra has a central hollow portion, neural canal, through which the spinal cord passes. First vertebra is the atlas, and second one is axis. The vertebral column is differentiated into 1. Cervical, 7. 2. Thoracic, 12. 3. Lumbar, 5. 4. Sacral 1 fused and 5. Coccygeal, 1 fused. The number of cervical vertebrae are 7, in almost all mammals, including human beings. The vertebral column protects the spinal cord. It supports the head, and serves as the point of attachment for the ribs and musculature of the back. Now, we can study the sternum and thoracic cage formation. It is formed by 12 pairs of ribs, and sternum ventrally, and thoracic vertebrae dorsally. Each rib is connected dorsally to the vertebral column, and ventrally to the sternum. It has 2 articulation surfaces on its dorsal end, and is hence called bicephalic. Ribs are classified into 3 types, as 1. True ribs, first 7 pairs of ribs are called true ribs. Dorsally, they are attached to the thoracic vertebrae, and ventrally connected to the sternum, with the help of hyoid cartilage. 2. False ribs, the 8th, 9th and 10th pairs of ribs, do not articulate directly with the sternum, but join the 7th rib with the help of hyoid cartilage. These are called vertebrochondral, false, ribs. 3. Floating ribs, last 2 pairs, 11th and 12th, of ribs are not connected ventrally, and are therefore, called floating ribs. Now, let us see the different bones of forelimbs and hind limbs that form appendicular skeleton, along with pectoral and pelvic girdles. Limb goes 1. Forelimb bones. The four limb bones are humerus, radius, and ulna, carpals, wrist bones, 8 in number, metacarpals, palm bones, 5 in number, and phalanges, digits, 14 in number. 2. Hind limb bones. Femur, thigh bone, the longest bone, tibia and fibula, tarsals, ankle bones, 7 in number, metatarsals, 5 in number, and phalanges, digits 14 in number. A cup-shaped bone called patella cover the knee ventrally, kneecap. Phalangeal formula in human is 2 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 equals 14. Pectoral girdle. It is formed of two halves. Each half of pectoral girdle consists of a clavicle and a scapula. Scapula is a large triangular flat bone, situated in the dorsal part of the thorax, between the second and the seventh ribs. The dorsal, flat, triangular body of scapula has a slightly elevated ridge called the spine, which projects as a flat, expanded process called the acromion. The clavicle articulates with this. Below the acromion is a depression, called the glenoid cavity, which articulates with the head of the humerus, to form the shoulder joint. Each clavicle is a long slender bone, with two curvatures. This bone is commonly called the collarbone. Pelvic girdle. Pelvic girdle consists of two coxal bones. Each coxal bone is formed by the fusion of three bones. Dash 1. Ilium. 2. Ischium. And 3. Pubis. At the point of fusion of the three bones, is a cavity called acetabulum, to which the thigh bone articulates. The two halves of the pelvic girdle meet ventrally, to form the pubic symphysis, containing fiber.